Do you believe in stakeholder capitalism, the principle that companies are beholden to a wide range of constituencies, employees, the community, the environment, and not just beholden to shareholders?
Oh, Eric, I think this is complicated in that the answer to your first question is yes. I believe you really need to understand how your company fits in with the world. And I teach MBA students at Stanford, and this is one of the things I drill into them, that the importance of context. I also think that if you're not executing, none of the good work you're doing on social context is going to keep you from getting fired. So it's necessary, but not sufficient to actually being able to run a company. And so all it really means is that the role of the CEO is more complicated today than it's ever been before, because you have to do all those things, but you have to actually be cognizant of, again, the way that your business needs to be operated and the commitments you make to investors and the primacy role that they have in terms of ultimately how the company gets valued.
But it sounds to me as though you believe that the world has moved on from Milton Friedman and the idea that a company has only one duty, and that duty is to its owners.
Yeah, look, I think we've had 50 years, let's say, of Milton Friedman, right? And we are where we are. Some good, right, in terms of competitiveness and innovation. Some bad, in terms of the impact on the environment and social justice and other things that surround the company. So I think that basically there has to be a more complicated, nuanced role that companies have. Look, my career basically spanned from, let's say, 1980 until 2017. For the first 20 years, basically leaders of my generation thought we could shut down factories, move the work wherever we wanted to. If wages were lower in India, or if wages were lower in Mexico, if wages were lower in China, we could just shut them down and move the work. And basically, people would love us and we would be fine. I think, it wasn't that President Trump changed that. That was already changing. People were already looking at companies and saying, it's hard for us to assess that you're a good member of this society when that's all you're doing. And so you start to see companies moving work back to the United States or thinking about different ways to manage the workforce. So I just think these things have changed, and CEOs today need to be aware of that and need to be on top of it and need to be ahead of it, actually. Anybody, basically, in 2020, in the era of COVID, that had a sole source manufacturing in China for a product, missed all the clues, right? They missed all the things that were going on around them that said, that's a high-risk strategy.